Nico, we are now in the Cryotherm laboratory of the Eindhoven University of Technology. Can you tell us in a few words what the topic of your research is?
Yes, we are looking into the possibilities to make materials in the way that nature does it. If we look at bone and teeth and shells, we see that nature can make very precise materials with shapes and properties that are designed precisely for that function.
Okay.
And by doing this, by trying to do this in the laboratory, we are now finding ways that we can make materials in the same way, with the same precision, both in shape and in the properties, so that we can make new materials. For example, for bone implants and biomedical imaging. And we're using this microscope to do electron microscopy at high resolution for these studies.
Okay, many thanks. In 2009, you published a paper about your research in Science, together with others, of course. You published the underlying research data for this paper in the 3TU Data Center. Why was that? What were your reasons for publishing your measurement data as well?
Now, one of the things we do is we're doing 3D electron microscopy. And this does not just generate flat 2D images, but 3D volumes. And because of the resolution of this microscope, these volumes contain an enormous amount of data. Now, these data are enclosed in a very, very big file, generally bigger than 1 gigabyte.
Yeah.
Now, these files have to be processed, and which generates even more of these big files. And for the experimental series that we published in Science, the data set was so big that they could not publish it on their website. So we were looking for other ways to publish these materials, and we found one in the 3TU data.
Nico, why do you think it's important that this data is available?
Now, if you process these data, you are making changes in the original data set. And I think it's very important that fellow researchers can look back into what were the steps taken in this process, so they can actually check if we did our job properly, but also people may use the same data set for things that we were not looking for things that they want to use for their studies, and so generate new science with the same scientific data set.
I understand, yes. So the public availability of research data is important for you. And I would like to add that the data sets in the 3TU data center are assigned a so-called digital object identifier, a DOI, so that they can be easily cited. Is it important for you that your data can be cited properly?
Obviously, everybody wants the recognition for the work that they have done. So if other people use it, you would like that to see that back. But the more important thing is that everybody can access it directly with one click of your computer mouse.
Okay. But some schoolers don't want to publish the data because they are afraid the data will be misused. I understand that's no argument for you?
No. In our case, we put their hard scientific data, and so what you see is what you get. And if people want to do something with that, it is their responsibility and not the responsibility of the person that makes their data available, I think.
Okay. So a final question. Would you in the future publish your data again in the 3TU Data Center?
Well, we are actually looking to place another data set there. The data set that we used for publication that just got accepted in Nature Materials.
Okay,
a journal
nice.
That does not have open access possibilities.
Okay, but the data will be open access available. Belonging to that article.
That's our idea. Yes.
Okay, Nico, many thanks for your inspiring contribution.
You're welcome.
Okay.